Hi guys, Phill Dale from Skarnsundet Fjordsundet here. Today we're going to try and fish for halibut. We're going to be using two different types of techniques. Fishing two rods, and one of them's going to be fished with a very big lure. Well, not a very big lure, considering the size of the halibuts. Halibuts can grow up to several hundred kilos. The fjord that we're in, the Trondheims fjord, generally our halibuts are between kind of 10 and 20 kilos, 20 to 40, 50 pound. There are much bigger halibuts here as well, but they're quite often lost because we tend to use quite light equipment at Skarnsundet. That's why we seem to lose them. But we do catch halibut here, so it's not as if there's absolutely no chance. We're giving it a go now. It's 12, we've just gone 12 o'clock, so we're going to fish for about 4 or 5 hours. We're going to fish the same area for this session. We're not going to move around, we're going to stick to one particular place. This is where we've caught halibut before. It's 15 minutes from Skarnsundet, straight over towards the island. It's a sandy, gravelly bank running from about 30 metres to about 45, 50 metres deep. Certainly the type of ground where they like to be, or certainly the type of ground that they like to lay on. I've not done a lot of halibut fishing from the boat. I've done a lot from the shore, but I have caught halibut from the boat before, and it's certainly not a difficult way to fish. Basically, for me, halibut fishing is about finding the right ground and putting the hours in and learning. That's pretty much how you catch halibut. There's no... The rigs aren't overly complicated, you know. It's either a dead fish or a piece of fish somewhere up near to the bottom within a couple of meters, or even in mid-water, depends what they're doing. Because we're fishing two different rods, two different rigs, we're going to fish one bait quite hard on the bottom, about a meter up from the bottom. We're just going to drift, and we're going to fish this lure, which is 120 gram head, a 20 centimeter long lure. We're going to fish that about 4 or 5 meters up from the bottom, just to try and see what's the most effective bait versus shad. That's the two main ways you can fish. We use a very simple bait rig. This is the bait rig we're going to be using. So it's a 400 gram lead, piece of 150 pound nylon onto a piece of big chunk of herring, and a 9-0 hook. Simple. Fish it off the bottom, don't jig it around a lot, just let the drift do the work, really. I've separated the rods apart, so we're on a 20 foot long boat. So I put one rod up at the front, one rod at the back, just so they don't get tangled up. We've got about 0.2 knot of drift, and we're drifting up the bank. It's not ideal. I'd prefer to see 0.5 knot of drift and drifting parallel with the shoreline. What that does, that gives me more time to fish on the ground where we know they are. If we're drifting up the bank's quite short, but it's very long. So it runs parallel with the shoreline, so really we want to be drifting parallel. But we've got what we've got, and we just have to make the best of it. I say we've got 4 hours fishing. I really hope we see one. I've never fished this time of year for them here before, so we have to see. We catch a lot in kind of spring, summer and autumn from this particular mark, anywhere from kind of £5 to £50. So equipment's quite heavy. This is a 15 to 25 pound boat rod with a TLD 2-speed. The reel's a bit oversized, to be honest, but it's just what I had. 35 pound braid onto an 80 pound mono leader, just as a rubbing leader. Yeah, and that's going to pretty much sit down near the bottom and just float along the bottom. Hopefully they're laid on the bottom with their eyes facing up. They see it coming over, they follow, they bite, and we get them. The shad's pretty much the same. The shad's fished on a little bit lighter rod, a Kanzagi rod, 1220. Quite light with a fathom multiplier, again 30 pound braid, 80 pound rubbing leader, top shot, standard gear really. I don't anticipate to catch a monster halibut here. That's why I've not overdone the equipment. This is far enough for what we do. But let's get some baits in the water and try it. I'll lower my shad down first. I've got a couple of these rod holders, these windy ones, so I can move them around. I think it's okay the way I've set them out. We're going to fish this one, let's say 2 or 3 metres up from the bottom, and we're just going to keep an eye on the sonar, so when we see the depth changing, we'll either let out a bit of line or we'll wind a bit up, because I don't really want to be touching the bottom. Although there's not many snags here, I don't want to risk getting snagged. So there, I've felt the bottom there. So just give it 5 times up, set the drag, put the ratchet on, and leave it. And then with my bait rod, just drop it down. Drop it down to the bottom. There's the bottom, muddy bottom. A couple of winds up. And then again, set the drag. Little bit of drag there. Put the clicker on. And that's it. Simple. And we just drift. I see we're actually drifting up the bank still. So we've got to 32 metres deep now. What we'll do is we'll let this drift up to about 30, 25, somewhere like that. We'll spin the boat around and we'll give it another drift. And we're just going to continue fishing like that for the next 4 hours. We can catch other species here as well. Cod, haddock, pollock. But it's predominantly halibut that we want today. I just touched the bottom then, so I just give it a couple of winds up, bring it up off the bottom. This one's, it's always good just to keep checking them. And now we wait. You know, halibut can be massive. So I've double checked all my knots. I've used FG knots for my braid. To my mono, for my opinion, it's the strongest knot to use. I've used a slightly heavier lead on my bait rod than I have on my shad, just so my bait rod stays directly below the boat and the shad has the ability to drift away a little bit, stops tangles and fishes different areas. Got a little bit wind coming, it's going to push us around a bit. That's it. Now we're fishing for halibut. So, stay tuned. Both rods are fishing well. Just sat here waiting. It's a very nice drift. You can see here, this is our drift line here. So drifting parallel with the shoreline, just where we want to be. We're 43.5 metres deep. You can see that line there. That's our bait rod. And one straight down. So the sonar's picking that up. So we're just drifting along this bank here now, 43.5 metres deep. We'll just continue like this really until this drift ends, which is somewhere kind of end of this screen here, at least 300-400 yards away. I've had one bite already on the bait rod. It just banged over and took a bit of line, then came off. So yeah, got the bait rod fishing there. And I've got my lure rod fishing here. I've been kind of actively using my bait rod as well, kind of jigging it up and down a bit more, winding into mid-water. There's the bridge, Skarnsundet. So you can see we're not so far away. And there's the island there, the one just in front of Skarnsundet. And over there, right in the distance, is Straumen. So yeah, feeling confident. It's just time. I'm just baiting up a trace ready for, because I'm going to replace mine in a minute on my bait rod. So I got a big chunk of herring, belly of the herring, and a 9-0 hook. Got in from the bottom and back out, and then I lay my fish along like that. It's a bit more streamlined. I always like the belly. It's got loads of blood and guts in it. And then I just use some thread like that, and I bind it on. In no particular way, as long as it's on. A couple of things I really try to do. See the eye of the hook here? I put my thumbnail over it and I press it in, and I put a lot of turns of thread on there. I think that secures my hook point a bit better. And then I just wrap up all the way up to the top of the fish bait. Try and make it a little bit presentable. Just keep an eye on my rods. And then just keep wrapping. See the blood starting to ooze out of that. This was fresh frozen herring, so it's quality bait. Lots of scent in it. See the blood in it there. So that's what you end up with. A bit more over the eye of the hook and over the knot, and then you see that ain't gonna turn. The worst thing that can happen is that turns into the bait here, and then when you get a fish or a strike, you don't have a hook point. So there we go, that's a 9-0 hook, big piece of herring, 150-pound nylon swivel. And now when I reel that into change, I can just put this on the quick link, drop it back in. Saves me quite a lot of time. It's always nice to have a couple pre-baited up. Got my cool box with me, so I'll just stick this in the cool box. Out of the... Just getting a bite. Strange bite. I think it's a halibut. Something there. Feels almost like a ling. On the bait rod. Quite a big piece of herring as well. It's woken up a bit now. What is it? Oh, God! No! Dreaded spare dogs! Nice spare dog there! The dreaded spare. There we go. That is a spare dog. Hence the big spare. Okie dokie, that's... Yeah, it's unhooked. There we go. Spare dog. Well, it's a fish. just slip that hook length off. Nice fish. There was a donkey and a stallion at Blackpool. The stallion's walking along this beach, just, you know, leisurely having a walk. Out comes this dog. They strike up a bit of a conversation, and you know, they become quite good friends to this donkey and this stallion. And this stallion says, "Why don't you come round tonight and sit down, make you something to eat, we have a nice meal." Donkey says, "Yeah, sounds like a great idea." So anyhow, he goes round and he goes into the stallion's house, and there's all these trophies of how many races this stallion's won. This donkey sat there thinking, "You know, I'm just a donkey at Blackpool." Anyhow, had a lovely night, and the donkey says, Why don't you come round to my house next week, stallion? And we can have a beer and I'll make you something to eat." The stallion thinks, "Yeah, it's a great idea." That 4 week, this donkey's giving these kids rides at Blackpool. Thinks to himself, "God, how can I impress this stallion?" So anyhow, next week comes, this stallion goes round to the donkey's house and goes into the front room. Donkey has put a picture of a zebra on his wall, and his stallion goes up. He says, "Oh, donkey, never knew you played football." The donkey said, "Yes, when I used to play for Newcastle." The zebra, the stripes. "I used to play for Newcastle." Getting a bite. It's a halibut. Can't be a small fish though. It picked up a huge piece of herring. A bit of weight there. 53 metres deep. Our drift's quite fast now. Like 0.9 knots, so I've just have to add a little bit more weight to this, but it's kept it down there. Could be another spare dog. And it's another spare. Nice. Big spare. Oh no! Damn! Bit the it was a nice spare dog. Oh well. Our short session today. We've been blown off by the weather a little bit, to be honest. Our drift's come up to 1 knot, 1.2 knots. It's just becoming a bit too fast. It's not far off coming in dark anyhow, but great to be back out fishing for trying to fish for halibut again. One thing I forgot to mention was, very important, a good gaff. 12 knots. obviously gaff the halibut. Bottom jaw straight through if you want to release them. Anywhere in the flank tends to damage them. But I've got a big net as well, which 20, 30 pound halibut can go in. But this is for the big ones. So yeah, good strong gaff, always very